everyone. This is Arcadius, and welcome back to Naval Creed. Today we will be reviewing the Japanese destroyer Minekaze. Now, this is a similar ship, or similar to a ship I already have previewed, that one being Shenyang, or as I have since renamed her, Kamikaze. The only difference is in gun layout. Now, I actually have buffed my Kamikaze since then, and ooh, that's not it. I have torps that go out to 7.5 kilometers, and my detection is 5.3, so I have upgraded her quite a bit. But she is most comparable to Minekaze as well. Now, Minekaze is not a bad ship, however, she does differ quite... Well, I shouldn't say she differs quite a bit. She is very much similar to Wakatake. So, to start off, you do have four guns. You can see there is the different gun layout for the rear two most or guns. These guns are the same ones you have on all Japanese destroyers at this tier. You have the 120 mils. You can upgrade them to 6 rounds a minute, but they still have 25 second turn time, and the damages are, you can see. The shell velocity is still good. Let's see here. Your health, you have 10,900, so not very much. Torpedoes go 7 kilometers, do 68 knots, really good rate of fire, and do max of 8,600 damage. Gun range is 7.6, and her speed is 39 knots. She is one of the fastest destroyers in the game. The only time a Japanese destroyer will ever reach 39 knots is at the top tier for Shimakaze. Everything else goes slower, so she is extremely fast. And she is, I want to say, built to be a gunboat, but I hesitate to say so because of how bad her guns are. Or at least, they're not bad, but they're very slow firing and very slow turning. So she's not supposed to be in a very active gunboat, but as of a long-range gunboat, I guess you could say. Well, mid-range, considering her actual range. She has six torpedo tubes. You got a double there, a double here, and a double there. We can check the angles of these in-game, but they are usable. Armor, well, you're a destroyer. Don't expect too much. AA, yeah, don't expect to shoot anything down. That's all I can say. Same AA defense as Wakatake with 3 and 6 at the same ranges. So your AA is still absolutely trash. Oh, you have one AA gun. So you can actually see the AA guns on this ship. Well, there's another one. But yeah, you're not going to shoot down any, if many, aircraft. But yes, she is very fast. She has good torps. A lot of guns at this tier, but not effective guns, I should say. It's all in how you use them. But like I said, she's not a bad ship. She's not a favorite ship. I have been using Kamikaze quite a bit, so I may enjoy this game more than I have in the past, but we'll see. So let's toss her into a game and see how we can do. Alright, and here we have ourselves a game. No battleships, no carriers, which this is the tier where you would start actually seeing carriers, tier 4, and a bunch of destroyers, and quite a few cruisers as well. So let's see, what threatens me the most? I would say Omaha. Omaha would be the most threatening thing out here. I'm the fastest ship out of all of these. Well, besides the other Minekazes. Alright, so let's see what we can do. I do have health buffs and speed buffs applied. Let's see what the torpedoes are going. So the torpedo angles are going to be different for each set, I believe. As you can see, kind of overlap there. So we can see what the angles are when we fire them. Gun angles, you can see, they're actually not that bad. I mean, it's not the best, but at least it's usable. Alright, so our torpedo range is 6.8, and I believe our gun range was 7.6, if I remember correctly. So, she is a very close range ship at this tier. But I do believe you can stealth torp. Yes, you can definitely stealth torp. We're just going to turn our AA off because we don't need it anyways. Here's the, okay, so our turning is kind of sluggish. I'm at full rudder, and we turn like a semi. But that is expected at high speeds. Hey, insta fire, nice. We'll see if that hits any. There's another Minekaze. Come on, twerps. Yes. One point. Alright, and let's try and gun down this Kuma. Because Kuma doesn't have... Okay, well, it does have enough armor to apparently shatter my shells. And let's see here. Just a little bit more. So you can kind of see you use your torps, and then you can use your... Wow, that was terrible. Your guns to finish up the ships that you cannot finish with torps. Come on. A little bit more. Torpedoes are all reloaded. Can you go down? No. Alright. Well, whatever. Someone will get her. Okay. This Omaha is close to going down. Maybe we can secure this. There we go. There's the Kumba. Oh, we don't have fires. See the Minekaze on the far left there. We're going to want to try and take her out as well. Oh, that was some pretty good damage. I am running her as a gunboat, but that's mainly because I have so many friendlies in front of me right now. So I don't really have a choice. I got four fires. Wow, okay, so there's a bunch of destroyers over here, so let's go tangle with these guys. Okay, all missed. I want to try and finish off this Minekaze. Because that'll be one less destroyer we have to deal with. I should finish her if I actually have a shell that hits. There we go. Boom. And put some torps here so you can see those are the angles for those. Maybe we'll get lucky. Come on. So she does suffer when it comes to maneuverability. She can outrun anything, but she pays for that with not being able to actually turn. So I'm going to slow down so I can turn a little faster. You can also do that with any ship. Let's see, do we get a lucky torp? Yes, we do. And it actually is not enough to sink her. That's surprising. That's alright. We have our guns. Or at least some of them. Can we dump some torps here? Finish off the Clemson. And finish off the Minekaze. These are... Oh, wow, 2 HP. The low tier DD games are quick if you play it right. Okay, you got it. And we have got the Clemson as well, because that is 2 torpedo hits, and you will not survive. I stand corrected. You will survive. There we go. Alright, so... Relatively good game. Now, I was not very much a fan of this destroyer, mainly because of how the playstyle is, but as I've played it more, and same with the Kamikaze, it is actually quite fun to just go between the torps and the guns and just damage as much as possible. If there were battleships in this game, it would be a lot harder. And carriers, if you're focused on... It's not... If it's a real player, it might be difficult, but bot players, yeah, you can just ignore carriers pretty much because they can't do much against you, and you can't do much against them. So how did we do? We did 83,000 damage, 5 ships sunk, 45 shell hits, 9 torpedoes, 4 fires. Now, we do have a buff to my fire chance, so don't take that as the ship has a really good fire chance because it probably does not. We can take a look at that in a moment. 3 floodings, 1 module destroyed, 2 defended caps, 4,000 base XP, and you can see that most of the damage was from torpedoes or shooting lightly armored targets like destroyers. So let's take a look at her fire chance. Yeah, 5.6%. With the rate of fire and the number of shells you have, I mean, yeah, you're going to get a few fires, but not a lot of big damage. So she's... Torpedoes are good. Like I said, you can stealth torp. What is her detectability? 6.2. What's my detectability? 5.6. So yes, you can easily stealth torp with the ship, and you can extend your torpedo range. You can decrease your detectability range. I don't have any of those skills at this time. I only have the basic ones that I'm working on. That being said, she can be quite a good player, or ship, I should say. You just have to realize that you are not the strongest, but you are pretty good. You're pretty fast, good torps, no AA, health is questionable, but she's not a bad ship. You do have to grind her, or play her, I should say, in order to get to the next destroyer in the line, that being Hatsuharu, if I click on the right one. So, I mean, she's not a bad ship. So I would definitely play her if you would have the chance to, or I should say if you want to grind her out instead of just skipping over her. I definitely would say Minekaze and the Hatsuharu line is better than the Wakatsaki and the Mutsuki line, but we will cover Mutsuki tomorrow and I will finish my explanation of why I say that then. She is matchmaking 4.0 as well, so Japanese does not have a matchmaking 3.0 destroyer. It goes from matchmaking 2, matchmaking 2, matchmaking 4, and then 5, 6, and so on. So, yeah, you will not... There's currently no matchmaking 3 destroyer, and I don't expect there to be, so that's also a neat little fact. With that, I will wrap up today's video. If you liked it, make sure you like and subscribe... Yeah, let me talk first. If you liked the video, make sure you like and subscribe for future videos. And tomorrow, like I said, we'll be going over Mutsuki, another fun destroyer. Note the sarcasm. All right. See you all tomorrow and have a good day. Take care.